Hello, hello, hello. Yeah, I've got a little bit of Warhammer 40K stuff. I haven't had a chance to really break into any of it. I don't really play it, but I bought them for the miniatures. So I love their miniatures. Their miniatures are really cool. I wouldn't say I'm really great at this, but I really enjoy doing it. So, all right, seem to have misplaced something here. Oh, there we go. Gotta have paint and my brush. Dun, 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 dun. Little tiny brush. Holy crap, really? That's cool. I've heard of that. That's how uninformed with 40K that I am. I have the Dark Vengeance. I had two copies of it. I gave one to one of my buddies, longtime buddies. And I broke mine open just to start painting it. I did that like a couple years ago. But I really think their detail is pretty impressive. Let's see. So what I was going to do is continue working on Travis here. Yesterday was just kind of like a test broadcast to see, and which of course my camera work kind of sucks right now, so please bear with me. Dun, 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 dun. Come on, focus. There we go. But I am going to push on and try to have some fun. Oh, totally get that, Dizzy. That's fine. I appreciate that. That's pretty awesome. Anybody out there, definitely check out Dizzy. She's a lot of fun to watch. Really enjoy watching your streams, Dizzy. I'll have to watch after I get off here. I'm only going to be on here for a couple hours myself. Trying to stick to a schedule and go with it there. So what am I going to do next? I think I got a nice little bit on for his skin, so might put a layer down for his pants and his, yeah, so let's find a nice color for his pants. Let's see if I got anything really good in here. Let's see, I got wolf gray, but that's, I almost need like a baby blue. Shock, Penny Fine. Oh, yeah. I've watched them. Electric Blue. Might have to add some dry brushing or whatnot to that. That's a little, it's close. If I don't like it, I'll lighten it up. How about that? Some of my homemade brew here for thinner. Well, I might not have to thin this as Army Painters more paint, so let's try that. Excuse me. I don't need a whole lot in there. Got the coffee jitters this morning, so that's going to be interesting. Let's pull this down just a little bit here. See where we're at. Yeah. I'm gonna slop this on here for a little bit. Yeah, that's all the same color there. Just kind of slopping on there. I'm going to end up starting to sound like fucking Bob Ross here in a minute. Just painting just the little heavy little places right down in there in the corner. Don't worry so much about getting stuff in the wrong places. And, you know, painting in the lines comes in a little bit later. Right now, certain areas you just want to get the color down. All right. I may put down a little bit of thinner here. Before I put the next coat on. Just get that in there. To get a good music thing going. Let me see if I can get this. Let's try that. You all might not be able to hear it quite as well as I do, but if I want my VODs to not get muted, I gotta keep my music down low. And quite frankly, I want to listen to what I want to listen to, not stuff I've never heard of before, so. And I'm just going to sit here and get in all these little tiny spots here. Just slap it on there. It's jeans, you know. I kind of like this electric blue. It's not too bad. Does it have to match 100%? No. If it had to match 100%, I believe they probably would have painted these for us. But I'm going to get it as close as I can with what I have. Oops. Just get a little bit of that in there. The zombies will be pretty freaking cool, because I'll probably do those in more of an assembly line. I got a little bit of a brush issue there. One second here. Get a little bit of thinner. This stuff to be too thick on me here. Here we go.
Should be a couple little spots on his pants right up in here. I'm just going to fill in there. Just a little bit in there. And this should be blue. Come back and get his belts and whatnot later. Yeah, there we go. Just a little bit in there. And that's all the blue I really need. I have to remember to come back and get that little bit of blood and whatnot right in there. It's a pretty neat game if you've never heard of Zombicide or have never played it. Definitely check it out. The logo is right there in the bottom left-hand corner. Really neat cooperative game that you can play. Fighting zombies, surviving. Very interesting. There we go. That's thinned out. Nice. That'll come across pretty good there. Hey, Cube. What? Yeah, I'm alive. I am alive. You know, as they say, sometimes stuff comes up. Life throws you a curveball. But I'm here. I didn't die. Yes, that's awesome, because, yes, I realized that because I just found out about that Prime, that Twitch Prime, so he got my free subscription, so I subscribed to him as soon as I signed up for that, so he got it. He wasn't live, of course, at the time, but... That is awesome. I am so glad that he got that partnership for him. He totally deserves it. He does a great job. I think, what is he? He's up to... And he just under 14,000 subscribers now, followers. Look, I'm flying back and forth between YouTube and Twitch subscribers, whatever. All right, so that is getting a little better. I'm gonna let that dry just a little bit before I put any more on there. Yeah, so he's grown about 5,000 or 6,000 since I last was on there, because I think he was around 9,000, wasn't he? Just under 10,000 when I first came across him. Let's see here. Now, I have some big plans for this stream. Well, not this specific stream, but this channel now that I'm back. I know the hours are going to be a lot different than what I normally did. Plus, the content's completely different. But I think you all will have some fun. If I get the viewership, it'll be even better. I plan on doing models on here, scale modeling and miniatures, so hopefully keep all the boring bits out of it. It's not bad. I can live with that. And unfortunately, this camera really does kind of suck. But I'll go with that color. And I'm not worried about it getting too filled in on there. It's got a leather jacket on with some like purplish overtones on it. So I think what I might do is do browns, which I'll find here. Yeah, he has done amazingly. He is absolutely awesome. I do have some. Come on, where's my browns that I want to use? Some oak brown. That's a nice dark brown here. Honestly, I don't care if there's any blue in that thinner because I'm going to end up putting purple on this, I think, too. So I'm going to use some oak brown. Oops, wrong brush. You ever do that? Wrong brush. Hey, plug away there, Dizzy. I was checking out your Steam. You're on your way to 500 games. I have 77. I thought I had way too many. you've got like 400 and some. I was like, what the? Holy crap. I was like, that's just insane. Gamers are gamers, though, I guess, right? I actually have that, I couldn't help myself. I've got the new Wildlands game. I don't think I'll ever stream that, but just something to tinker around with, to have some fun with. I'll give his boots some color here. Yeah, some slop it on there. Detail work will come later. And get a little bit of detail in here. I gotta match up that line. Let's see. Put down some base layers. Those gloves. We'll come back to that one. Let's get this jacket. I'm probably going to do a little bit more purple. Purplish blue for his t-shirt, which I'll come back and do that. I'll get that started while I'm waiting for this to dry. Because I probably should have done that first. To sit in a room like a cooker this summer. Nice. Yeah, you don't want to overheat. That's not good for you or the PC. Not good at all. Hey, Big Roser, thanks for the follow. I still got that sound clip. I love that. Dr. Glue on. Hey, what's going on, buddy? Yeah, you can't exactly put a drink in the computer. That would be disastrous. Sitting here chilling and painting. Not quite the Bob Ross, but I completely and utterly enjoy doing this kind of stuff. So I have missed you two. I have missed Glooby also. I've been checking out some of your VODs. I hate the fact that I've been gone so long. You crack me up, man. You absolutely positively just crack me up. I have these new hours. Life and family take precedence right now, but working on this schedule, I should be able to balance everything out a little better. And it should leave me time to watch some of my favorite streamers out there. Like you, sir. And Dizzy. I might not be able to catch Dizzy live because I'm pretty much doing this the same time you are. Hey, no problem, Doc. That glad to do it. Glad to do it. I am so happy to hear that you got partnered too. That is absolutely awesome. I am glad to hear that. You deserve it. Oh, thanks, Dizzy. Thank you so much for that. You guys are all pretty awesome. I really miss the community. Whoops. I know the first thing I'm going to do is get another camera. Because this thing is driving me nuts. It's an El Cheapo. Well, I guess it's not. Well, it's probably cheap now, but
I'm getting there.
Let's see. He's got all kinds of straps and all kinds of crazy crap down through here. During this stage, everything kind of looks a little blah. Till you start getting all the depth into it and everything like that. Getting everything to cover and but it comes in.
Put an Amazon wish list up?
Oh yeah. I should probably do that, shouldn't I? I've been doing some research trying to figure it out what exactly I'm gonna need. That's too much paint. I gotta get, just throw that on there because I'm gonna make a mess of it anyway. And it's paint. Semi-permanent. It doesn't have to be completely permanent. You can always go back over it and fix it. There's a little strap in there, and he's got a mustache. Because for the viewers, I'm sure you would like a much better view of what I'm doing instead of how this is probably coming across. My big screens that I used to use for computer monitors, I now use like normal people do and use them for TV. So right now I'm using a Samsung 32, but it's old and the color's a little off on it. It does look fine. Okay. Well, thank you. I can't tell how good it comes across because, like I said, it's so small. I'm used to having multiple screens and I don't have multiple screens anymore. So, which, if I'm not streaming games, I don't really, per se, need that extra screen. But it is nice and convenient when you're trying to watch chat and see what your stream is actually coming across as. So I may have to go to my other brush here. This is kind of pissing me off here. It's a little thick. These models are so flippin' small. Alright. I got a nice... You know what? The effect of this brown, other than where I have some lights on it, with a little bit of that black showing through, I kind of really like that. It gives it that worn leather look. Just hit it a few different areas. Getting late, so I'm off to bed. It was good hearing your voice again. Have fun. Hey, thanks, Dr. Gluon. Appreciate it, buddy. I will have to sneak into your room sometime here and watch your stream. When are you going to be up again? I'm sure I'll get the notification. And have a great, great day, sir. Hey, thanks for the host there, Dizzy. See, what is that? Oh, there is some little tiny spots underneath there. Now, the difference with that and that, yeah, I like that.
11 Central, 12 Eastern. All right, awesome. Well, I'll be up and about and probably have you on my phone. So I will stop in and say, hey, get some rest, man. That's only a few hours from now. Unless you're talking midnight, which you probably are. Not noon. But anyway, yeah, I'll be. Oh, hey, Lady Clay, thanks for the follow. Have a great day. Enjoy your rest there, Doc. Good seeing you again, buddy. Or at least talking to you. Yeah, it's midnight. Yeah, I've been away for a while. Painting the little boots. Just get them some color on there. There are a lot, and I'm talking a lot of characters, main characters for this game, Zombicide. Well, I guess comparative to Warhammer, it doesn't have a lot, but. I mean, there's like 30, close to 30, and then if you did the promos and stuff like that, you would have gotten a lot more, which I didn't. I didn't find out about this game until, I don't know, about a month or two, and I just absolutely love this game, Zombicide. I'm going to go to my small brush and get some of these little fine details. These fine lines in there. Firefly. I want this one. Yeah, I'll try this one for now. Because I want to fix a little bit of my blue in there. This little sumbitch is a small... Shit. Just a small... You know what, that's probably going to end up just all shadow by the time it's all said and done anyway. Once I put the wash on it. Hey, Zim, what's going on, buddy? I gotta fix some of those. What's up to this early morning there, sir? Yeah, it still says that. I gotta fix those. Oh, nice, nice. I got rid of a lot of the commands. So those might not work. But I just kind of haphazardly went through some of those. All right, so... His glove, I'm just going to put a little bit of brown on there because I'm going to go back with some mixed black. I don't want to use pure black on his gloves, but just soften some of this crap up. Yeah. Dude, that's awesome. Almost 500. I'm surprised I didn't lose any followers while I was gone.
I mean, I may have lost a couple, but, like, a lot more than I did. Being gone. An awesome paramedic. There's a GTA 5 RP role-playing server now. Oh, that's cool. I don't have GTA 5. I played it on Xbox when it first came out, but I got rid of it. I didn't really stay in it. Which probably should have, but it's okay that I didn't. All right, there's that. I'm getting there. A little bit of color there, a little bit of color there. These things are so damn small. It really wasn't GTR Live friendly. Oh, dude. Don't even worry about that. GTR Live friendly. What's that mean? Well, they're your paints, man. Anything that you have to give back. My goodness. I painted them. I learned a long time ago, have no regrets. So, it would have been nice if things would have worked out better for that and everything, but honestly, some good things have come out of it. I think OCTV is doing an absolute awesome job. So, and I like the directions that they've gone with some of the stuff. Besides, growth is never a bad thing. And I have been seriously contemplating whether or not to change the name of the stream from GTR Live to something else. But I just can't bring myself to pull the trigger to change it from GTR Live. So for now, it's staying GTR Live. It may not make a whole lot of sense when you're putting that next to whatever I'm doing on here now, but who cares? It's what I'm doing, so. And it's not exactly easy to find something that works with Roscoe anyway. Classy Pack's been a big help. Cool. That's awesome. Well, I'll promote you, Zim. Give Zim a follow. Check him out. Always liked watching you, Zim. Let's see. That belt and that shirt. Some really, really small brushes. Also, I was wondering, your time zone changed. I was like, how is he so many hours different than me now? So, that makes sense. Now I know why. So, you got there for a job that you're doing? typing. I hate typing too. That's why I got a mic. So, yesterday, I had some company here, and they wanted to see some of the models that I have been working on. So, I took a couple of them upstairs and was showing them and talking. And then one of the latest ones that I just finished, which was a 69 Nova. I think it was 69. Was it 69 Nova? Yeah, 69 Chevy Nova. I turned with it in my hand. You know where this is going. And I just caught the edge of the countertop to my left. It knocked it out of my hand and hit the floor and broke into about 30 pieces. Just small parts. The wheel stayed on. That was nice. Ah, I gotcha. Makes sense there, Zim. So now, that Nova is going to be... It's in a box right now to get some surgery done to it and re-glued back together. Didn't look like anything broke. Excuse me. It was a clean accident, I guess. I don't know, however you want to say it. So, ooh, that's too much paint. How it's gonna end. Listening to Breaking Benjamin. This is how it's gonna end. The zombie apocalypse. Ah! I'll be giving Zim a call if that happens. Help me out, buddy. You know about these things, don't you? All right. Got that. Let me, Lucky 7. It's the 7. The curse of the 7. Dee-dee-dee. All right. I need... That's dark. Dark, 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 dark. Yeah, a little bit of alien purple. And... some gray, maybe? Was it the lucky car or the unlucky car? I forget. It's usually the unlucky. Most definitely the unlucky. Because I always bet 7, and if I bet 7, then that's what happens. All right, so let's try some of this wolf gray and maybe some alien purple in it. I don't know. Use that for a shirt. I'm talking just a dot of the purple. A dirt track schedule here. There is races from February to November. Oh, nice. That'll get me just dark enough, I think, for that shirt that he has on. Holy shit! Forgot about that thing popping up, too. There was a troll about iRacing dirt. And now look.
Yeah, no kidding. Yeah, just when mine's about to expire, they come out with dirt. Just how it goes sometimes, I guess, huh? It's all right. I don't have the room to actually get on there. The only thing that I would ever do, which is primarily what I did anyway, was paint, so I don't have the time to actually stream iRacing. Oh, that's not a good place for it there, Zim. Kind of hard to race without a wheel, ain't it? I becoming a monster just like you. Okay, so his shirt's in there. It's not looking too bad thus far. Where is... see, I got my matte black, but I don't really want to go that straight black. See, I got some purple tone there that I can use for my jacket. I'll play it for dirt. I have better games on Steam. I need a really nice dark gray. Like an ash gray. All these different colors in here, and I'm just a little short on the one that I want. All right, let's try. Well, actually, where'd I go? Does it? I will go back and do that. Kind of hard for me to watch anything on my computer the way I'm sitting. Send that to me in a private message too. You're on my friends list, I'm pretty sure. This has got like a his crossbow, his bow and arrow thing, his bow. It's got kind of an off color. It's almost got a bone color. I wonder if I should use some bone. That. No, I'm gonna give it some gray because when I thank you, sir. That way I know I will have that saved. Let's get this bad boy painted up here. Yeah, I like that color of it. I'll go back and because it's metal, but it's not like shiny metal. I don't know if that makes sense. I don't want to use that one. I'm going to use the bigger one for this. Get dizzy, you'll get a laugh. Coffee is sitting over there getting cold because I just didn't drink it. It's terrible. So, What's the big thing that you've been streaming there, Dizzy? I don't think she heard me. Once, but not again. Get in those tight little spots there. Give me a little bit more. Ooh, that's a little too much more brush. Not to worry. That will come back off. Not at all. I will have to check that out after I'm done here. Getting there. Coming along. Alrighty. I will still be here, Dizzy. Well, that's crazy small. Yes, it is very, 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 very small. It's 1/48 scale, actually. I keep forgetting to bring a quarter down here. But other than my hands for comparison of size... It's hard to tell how big these are. Think I got that almost where I want it. It's just a little bit. Now I get to go back over it again. Bring the color of it out just a little better. Got quiet. Sorry.
Really, really concentrating here.
I'm liking the gray here that I used. I'll go back and add some blacks in there for the pulleys and whatnot. Give it a little bit more depth. Takes time. Get all that depth to come out in these things. All right, so far, so good. So there's a Sharpie. That's how small they are. Which I have. So let me measure over here. Centimeters. He's 4 centimeters tall. Just shy of 4 centimeters tall. Which I guess in inches is an inch and a half. Just shy of, or just around an inch and a half. Yes, very insane. But very gratifying to actually get them painted correctly. I will say, on this picture, he has a little shark on his shirt. I'm not painting a little shark on his shirt. Sorry, that ain't happening. But, you know, I said I wasn't going to go straight black, but it's flat black, and I think I'm going to do that. Get some of this other stuff darkened back out. Hard to believe that I can paint something this small. Burm, burm, burm,
Sim's like, screw that. No, man, that's the challenge, man. It's a challenge to see if I can actually do it, and I enjoy it. I mean, there's some things, there's some things you just, unless you're a master painter, I guess, you're not going to get the detail of. But if you can get the illusion that it's there, that's part of it. His gloves are actually black.
mess with that one. Just put a little bit of this black around here. Then I'm gonna go back with the smaller brush because that's some tight area. Give this gun a nice fresh black over on it because I'm going to put some gunmetal on it. Which will make it stand out a little better. That it's not turning out too bad. These guys painted up just a little bit here. I'm going to leave that light paint at the end because I should have some neon green to throw up in there. Got to get the shadow out of my, there we go. Get the quicks painted with a neon. That'll look cool. His gloves. They're actually black now. Getting there. Clean the brush. Okay. Where is... There it is. Little itty bitty brush. A little bit of black. Gotta stop bumping the camera. Okay. Nice and slow. I'm out of focus, ain't I?
Haha. Getting there. Nice thing about working with acrylic paints, they dry really quick. The bad thing about working with acrylic paints is they dry really quick. So, it's good because you can handle the model pretty much right away, but bad thing is they dry so damn fast that, like, most of the stuff in here is dry. I have some thinner that I use, but only lasts so long. I gotta quit bumping the damn camera. Doing the backside of his gloves is fun. This is my challenge, to do these little boogers like this. Gotcha. That's the backside of that glove. See, I said, eventually you get into these little details here. This is the backside of this mace of whatever the hell it's called. Urban mace, I think, is what it's called in his hand. This is nasty. Oh, shit. Yeah, that ain't gonna hurt anything. There we go. All right. We need to do some highlights here and there. His boots don't look too bad. I think I'm overall happy with the black. Need a little bit more of that brown. Just on his... Yeah, there we go. Break that up just a little bit. That's better. So you can see his little pouch over there. Well, what the hell? Let's try this. I gotta clean some of that out. Get me some different colors in here now. Clean this up. Use that thinner. That'll at least get some of this junk up out of here. Don't want to waste that, though, because that's the... There we go. All right, I need my neon. Got that. Where did my good stuff go? Gotcha. does not need thinned. All right. That's for the little arrows. If you can see very well, but it's kind of like a greenish and some yellow is in there. I'm just going to slap it on there for now. Get me a little bit of a base. And down, over, around, through here. The molding on that is more round than anything, so it's a little odd looking. Almost looks like he's got a bouquet of flowers. Hey, have a good night, or a good day there, Zim. Not night, I guess, if you're going to bed this early in the morning. Anyway, good seeing you, buddy. There we go, that's better. Huh. I can live with that. Overall, not too bad. I like it. I likes it. Bring that up just a little bit more. Damn brush has got a curl on the end of it. There we go. Let's try that. Better. It's like green fire is what it looks like. All right. Those are done. Or that part's done. Need another paper towel. What happened to my music? What the hell? Where's my music? That's better. All right. So, I need to lighten his beard up, like, ever so slightly. He's got kind of like a grayish tone to it. It's almost like a bright dry brush technique that I'm using, I guess. I don't like
that side view of his mustache. So I'll go back through and get him some more flesh on there and tighten that up. But dusting across his beard here with this gray is exactly what he needed. So I'll fix his mustache on the side of his face. I don't like the way that looks, so I'm going to get some flesh back in there. Which I don't have, but the cheap stuff for my flesh, so. And I'm okay with that, because you know what? After all, it's just paint. There's nothing wrong with cheap paint. Other than that's cheap. Less expensive, not cheap. Little bit thinner in it, so that, because the less expensive stuff is super thick. It's just like folk art, apple barrel, whatnot. You can use pretty much any kind of acrylic. You thin it out, right? Give it a nice mix, and that's good. Nothing wrong with that. All right, so let's trim up his face just a little bit here. Just don't like that angle. This side I don't mind so much. It's just that right there, just probably over thinned that. Another day. Well, shit. Okay, got that. A little bit of the next step here.
some colors I don't mind mixing a little bit, but that green, I don't want that on anything else. That just would look awful. All
right.
I'm going to try to shade his jacket a little bit there. Because it has a purplish overtone. So I'm going to use some quick shade purple. See how she looks here in a minute. That bubble in there is kind of crazy. Yeah, that's the tone I want right there. It's giving it just like a little bit of a... It's going to give him just a little bit of a purple tone to that jacket. Mostly just the light from the way that the artist depicted the light coming down on him, but I like that purplish hue that it added to that leather. Gotta want to kind of get that in there a little thick so it shows your depth. That's what you're using these quick shades for.
Thanks, Dizzy.
Boots. I got another one. I'm going to dirty up his pants so it's not going to have the purple hue on his pants. I'm going to use like a light shade on that. You know, that just kind of pulls the details just a little bit. Come on, focus. Focus. What the hell? There we go. They're subtle differences, but they're in there. All right. So now I gotta do the blue, which it's gonna be dirtied up. Plus, I'm gonna give a little bit to the to his skin too, so he won't be so bright. Dun, 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 dun.
use the blue for the pants. And soft tone for the rest of it. Sure, why not? Let's try some blue tone. I don't know if that's going to be too dark. But I'll live with it. Now you should see the big difference in this compared to the purplish one. There we go. Quick shade. The way those paints are turning out, which I'll probably pull a little bit of that out of there. I gotta pull some of that up out of there. I don't want that on there. It's going to get some black shade on it. There we go. I don't know if you can see that or not. All right, next shade. Where's my, there's my paper towel. Use some soft tone. Like a dirty tone. There we go. Get that nice there. That pulls out into the face a little bit. Nice. All right. One more should be my dark tone, which is like a black. And I'll get that on the weapon. Coming along nicely. Shake these up. Looks black, doesn't it? Wow. Yeah. Okay. This is going on here. This weapon all nice and darkened up here. Perfect. That is just about the way I want it. I likes it. Not too bad. What do you think? I think it looks like a pretty good representation of the character that is on the card. Thing is now I'll let it dry for a day, and then I'll hit it with some right? Let it dry, and then I'll hit it with some flat varnish, and it'll take off all that shine because it doesn't need that shine on it. Well, I think Travis turned out pretty good. Yeah, I can't refer myself. Plus, I don't think that promo code works anymore, and it's only for new members. It's all right. They won't get rid of all my stuff on my profile or my membership. It's I'll just, when I have a chance, which will probably be like November when they do the Black Friday stuff, I'll just buy it for half price and then get another year. But it is what it is. I'm not that worried about it. I am completely thrilled of how this guy turned out. It's not too bad. Like I said, once he dries up a little bit, those inks, I don't want to hit it with the varnish, the flat yet, until the inks have a chance to completely dry and settle down. But overall, I'm pretty happy with that. I was going to do some gunmetal on his Uzi, but, I mean, looking on the picture, it really is just black. So, I think I'll just leave it. I mean, hell, they're this big anyway. Next one I'm going to do, I'm not sure of. But let's see here. Put that card away. I already did Phil. I did Elsa. I've got Doug done. Let's see. Who else do I have finished here? Wanda is finished. She was bitch. Amy, she's done. Josh is done. He's still my favorite one that I've ever done. The holes in his jeans and stuff like that just turned out really, really well. I think those are the only ones I have done now. I don't think I'm missing any now. But how many more do I have to go? One. Let's see. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. I got him done. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So I have 24 more to go. And I have, what is this, 7 done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 completed. Oh, yeah, I have that, Dizzy. I do have that. As soon as I saw that on Steam, I picked it up. So, yeah, definitely check it out. If you don't want to spend the dough on the actual game, you can use Tabletop Simulator. Oh, definitely. We'll have to do that sometime, Dizzy. Definitely have to do that. I have a group of friends that we have been coming over here. We, I went crazy and found all the campaigns, all the missions off their website, and went and had them printed out into books. Because they're all PDFs, real nice quality book pamphlets and stuff. So we've been playing some campaigns and stuff because I own all the original Zombicide sets. I don't own any of the new one, the medieval, which is funny. It's the new one, but it's set back in the past. But anyway, so yeah. I got all 3 seasons plus Angry Neighbors, Toxic City Mall. I've got the both VIP packages, the Ultimate Survivors package, the Zombie Dogs, and the other dogs, like the pets or whatever the hell you want to call them, companions. So. Interesting. I really like the way he turned out. That purple hue was just perfect for that. All right. Well, I think I am done for this morning. That was actually quite a quick stream. It was only, what, a couple hours? 5 o'clock till 7? So, I'm quite shocked that I made it through all the way through this morning. So, it didn't take as long. I'm getting a little quicker at painting them. Originally, they took me 4 hours to do one from start to finish. So, that is definitely doing better. So, eventually, when my parts and stuff come in, I ordered some aftermarket stuff for my Meng Leopard 1A5. It's a 135 scale. So when those come in, I'm waiting on the gun barrel and a couple other little tidbits. When those come in, I will continue building on this. In the meantime, I'm going to keep going with Zombicide. Zombicide is a lot of fun. I enjoy the game, and compared to games like, let's say, Warhammer, which I know you can't really compare these two because it's not nearly the same. But as far as miniatures, if you want to get into painting miniatures or something like that, the cost of Zombicide, game ready to play, each expansion, whatever, standalone season, the miniatures, you get a ton of them. They don't have to be put together.
And as you can see, they're very detailed. Not to mention all the zombies. These are just the characters. I have hundreds of zombies that I need to paint. And they can all be done differently, which is going to be a lot of fun. So, anyway, I want to thank everybody for stopping by. Thanks again, Dizzy, for the host, and thank you. It has been awesome seeing you and catching up. And if you've not seen Dizzy, hop over to her page and give her a follow. She's pretty great. And I guess until next time, I should be on here tomorrow morning around 5 a.m. Eastern, give or take a few minutes. So thanks again, and catch you later.